As a low temperature physicist, there are plenty of things that we can do where the properties of materials change in unexpected ways when you cool them down. And it's really exciting for me when I have a new group of students that come along and they see something that just amazes them. And they get to interact with it. They get to poke it and touch it and have a think about what's going on. And then we can spend some time discussing why is it that it's doing that and what's the underlying physics that causes this really strange thing that's not behaving in the way that you might have expected. In our program, we have something called stranding, where we say, what is it that you're really interested in? And if you want to pursue that, what choices do you need to start to make? So we might have people that want to be particle physicists or people that want to be astrophysicists, and we guide them through different routes in which they get to the end of the 3 or 4 year program that they're studying, and they're now suitably qualified to embark on a career in that area or take on further study. I assign our summer placements. So we have various schemes that we work with. There are big international research facilities like CERN and ISIS and DIAMOND. We have research projects that I run, that the research groups run within the university, where maybe 10 to 15 of our students spend the summer working alongside a research group. And then we have a thing called SEPNET, which is a regional network of physics departments, which organize, has employment liaison officers, and they go out to industry and attract people to have project students working with them. And that allows our students to go out and work in an industrial environment. Employers aren't necessarily interested in exactly what mark you got in a quantum mechanics exam, but if you can explain to them a piece of work that you did over several months, where you had to write it up, you had to prepare a report, you had to communicate what it was to other people that you did, you had to follow through with plans, you had to have a technical level of ability to actually get there, that's a really powerful tool, and it really discriminates a good student in an interview situation from somebody who just got good grades in an exam. And so our students all leave here with that document that they produced, a really good piece of work that they can talk about enthusiastically because they did it. And it's not just something they learned, they really spent the time in the lab with the experts in those fields. They were working alongside the academics and got to really understand what it is like to work in that area.